Good evening. Welcome to my end of the week recap here for the S&P 500 and plan ahead for next week. First of all, play I did get into on Thursday was a breakdown of this 270 level at some 270 puts here at 154. Half out at 175 on the initial drop. The rest of them trailed me out at 143. This stop loss was a little bit too tight. Should have left it up here above VWAP, but can't trade with shoulda, coulda, woulda. So I will work on that. I will improve and get better with these types of trades. And do better in the future. So going forward, price action held the support level I was looking at down here on 266.5, 267. So I did get in some 20 April 284 calls at 56. There was a lot of volume in those this day, so I was following it. Just like the thought process behind it, the mentality, like the position. So we'll see what happens going forward with those. Into the day on Friday, only took one position, added into some 29 March 282 calls at 27. Excuse me, didn't add into, but started a new position for another swing play. Again, saw some volume in these that I liked and kind of liked the thought process behind it for a move up higher. If it's going to break this this overall trend, it looks like we have now a first higher low in relation to the 200 SMA. So either this is going to be a dead cat bounce and a very, very ugly rollover once it comes up to these moving averages, or it's an actual bounce and we get to see a new relative high in relation to the 200 SMA. Still have this flag pattern drawn in here, which I've adjusted a little bit. Pole still the same length, flag still about the same, but I've moved my measured move down here to just where the buying started today, around 265. So price target is now around 287.5. We'll see if it does get up there. Plan for Monday on the open. There's a big, huge red spot right here that I just kind of transferred over to the new day. Excuse me. All the moving averages are still here between 271, 273. Anytime I've had a major either support zone below price or resistance zone above price, market makers have seen that and like to rally price the opposite way through there. So if that holds true, we'll see if that happens. We'll get a nice move up here, maybe around 275, all the way up here to around 277.5, maybe 280-ish area. That's just a little bit of planning ahead. Now, if price action does come up here, hit some harsh resistance, turns into a very bearish price action, I will close out my calls and swap to puts really quick for a move back down here to at least this rising trend line. So that would negate this type of a bounce. Like I said, this may turn into a dead cat bounce, come up here, find resistance, and roll over all the way back down here to maybe even the 200 SMA. Maybe it needs to test it again before it starts to make a new high. Who knows? But one thing I want to point out here on the daily time frame is we now have what looks like is setting up as a triangle or a wedge pattern that is not necessarily a reversal pattern, not historically anyways. It's more likely a consolidation before we have another move. So if you have a consolidation after a move, most of the time that move after consolidation is in the direction of the previous trend. So most likely we're going to go up, in my opinion anyways. This is not investment advice. These are all just my plans. So I'm looking for new highs up here around 287. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them below. Sign up for the Trade Crew chat room. It's free. Chat with us live all day. Have a good weekend and good luck.